Hey YouTube, so this is Garrowin or Marcus with another video. I'm going to work on a PC build here today. This one's going to be a little bit different. I'm not actually building a new machine with this. What we're doing is we're basically transplanting the guts of a computer that my brother had into a new case, and he's going to use it basically as a home file server. It's an old, Lord, I don't know, it's a some old as hell AMD single core processor, but for a file server, perfectly fine. We've added a 6 terabyte hard drive and moved the old motherboard and things into a different case, so but the old power supply would not fit. We actually had to order a special TFX power supply to fit his case. So that's what I'm going to install today, and hopefully get it ready to roll for him. Alrighty, so right now we've just got everything sort of laid together here because we wanted to get it in here and then test it and make sure everything worked. And so you can see the drives sit, let me make sure there's nothing plugged in here. The drives sit here, and then this locks up when you elevate it. You have to excuse the mess. Between moving into the new house and building computers and getting stuff in the mail, everything's been kind of a mess. This is like the front bezel, power button, USB ports. I'll tell you how old it is. This motherboard doesn't even support USB 3, so there's actually an adapter in the mail to adapt this to the USB 2.0 headers on the motherboard so that these USB 3 ports in the front of the case will work. They'll just be USB 2 instead of USB 3. We both kind of made a mistake the other day, the first time I've ever really done this, but the SATA connector on this 6 terabyte drive, I don't know why they oriented it this way in this case, but the drive is oriented this way, and you can't turn it the other way because then your SATA connector is butted up against this, so your SATA connectors have to be pointed this way. But the lip of the case right here is right up against this, and so when we went to close it with the connectors plugged in, it broke the plastic off of the SATA connector on this brand spanking new 6 terabyte storage drive. But it still works. The gold contacts are pointed out, they're not bent, they're straight. I took the piece of plastic that was broke and pushed it into a SATA cable and then plugged it on. It actually locked onto the gold contacts where it wouldn't come off on its own, and it stayed in place, and we formatted the drive and spent several hours actually moving data onto it. So I'm just going to leave it alone. I'm not going to plug them in. What I'll do is I'll close everything up, plug the SATA cables in, and then I'm going to put some super glue on it where it plugs into the back of the drive, because we're not planning on ever removing this drive unless it fails. And if it fails, I'll buy him a new SATA cable. I've got 100 SATA 3 cables laying around, so no big deal here. But if you buy this case, what is this case? I don't even know. It's an Antec something or other. The front bezel looks like this. It's like a home theater PC type of build. Like the old IBM kind of horizontal builds. Watch if you put a 3.5-inch drive right here, because it definitely, and the right angle cables we have were angled incorrectly. They were angled where they would want to come up like this, and then the cables would have been like jammed here and made a lump in it. So unless they make a reversed right angle SATA connector that will plug onto a drive and then go that direction, you know. But anyway, so right now I need to get up because we've got his old power supply sitting in here because we just wanted to test everything and make sure it all worked. But this power supply won't fit properly, so we basically need to replace it with this one that we just got in the mail here. This Athena Power TFX 300 watt power supply. It's actually bigger than the one that was in the machine. This was an old E-Machines computer, is what it was. So we'll go ahead here and unplug everything. We've got a put an SSD in here for the operating system, a SanDisk plus, I think it's like 120 gigabytes. So, CPU, motherboard, SATA, that should be all of it. So, let's see if this one fits. Oh, it's definitely shorter, and it has Molex, and it comes with its own power cord. I like it when they come with their own power cord, because you never really know if, I don't know if these are standard size or not, but it always kind of makes me feel better that, you know, we know that this cord will carry the load that this power supply will draw. But it did not come with screws. Just notice that. It did not come with screws. Well, I've got a whole little baggie of screws here. We'll find some that'll fit it. Oh, man, it does. It's just a very perfect fit. There it is. This is the most useful tool that the Army ever gave me. There we go. So, let me see. Let's separate our wires here. Motherboard power. We will run that. And it's 20 plus 4. So, what that means is the 4 on this side here are actually a separate piece. So if this motherboard only takes 20, we can take those, like it does, we can take these other 4 off. Let me see. It slides one direction or the other. There we go. Okay, so this one, these don't slide, these just kind of snap into place. And you can use only the 20 that it actually takes. I always get really nervous mashing these power connectors on the motherboard because logic dictates that you should not have to press that hard on fiberglass, but I guess you just kind of be gentle and wiggle it around and eventually it does its thing. Let me get a zip tie for that here. Kind of zip tie. I'll take care of the zip ties here later. We'll fold that back there. So let's see if we can we put this little well, that's a Molex connector for that front case fan. So we actually get to use the Molex here. So we'll plug this guy in. Bam. And that'll run the front case fan. And then we can bundle all these wires up and sort of zip tie up here. Maybe I can just kind of stuff them down in here because there's no fan down here. So just kind of, and then zip tie these two together after it's lowered here. Alright, so let's make sure we don't catch that data cable there. Power cable is going to have to go on as well after it's lowered. I really don't like. Okay, so that's the one for my optical drive, so I can pull that one over there. Let me get in my chair over here where I can see a little better. Oh, God. The SATA connectors on the optical drive are going to point right into the power supply. Even if I've got a right angle cable for the data cable, the power connector right here, look at this. So, let's see if I can kind of get it mashed down here without hurting too much. CPU power, SATA power, think. I don't know. He may have to do without a. He may have to do without an optical drive. Because that power supply is mashing right into it. Let's call him and see what he says. Hey, Wetzel?
Yeah.
Question.
Yeah.
I've got your power supply installed. However, your optical drive sticks back right up against where the wires come out of it. And, I mean, they're mashing the shit out of these wires. I could try to bend them at like a 90 degree angle, but I would be afraid of breaking a coating on one or something causing a short somewhere. Do you want to take the optical drive out and just go without it? Because the 5 1/4 inch bay that it's in is tapered. It's got like cutouts where I believe I could fit the wires back inside there where they wouldn't be bent so sharp if the drive was gone. But it's up to you. Do you want me to try and mash them and get it in there, or just take it out?
No, just take it out.
All righty. I'll take a picture here.
I don't want to have pressure on, constant pressure on electrical wires and stuff like that that you cause that could maybe cause problems down the road.
Yeah. I'll take a picture of it here, and I'll send you a picture of what I'm talking about. And the thing is, like, the data cable is okay, I think. It's close to the power supply. But, like, the SATA power cable and the cords that are coming out of the power supply are all trying to be squashed into, like, a little quarter or half-inch gap here. But, all righty, I'll take it out, and I will, I'll send you a picture of what it looks like here in just a second.
All
right. See ya. Now, I think it will close up much better because, make sure nothing's getting bound up here. Yes, that's much better. We can take this one. Nothing's getting tied up or twisted or anything like that, so we'll take this SATA cable from that one. We'll move it to the, no, this is a SATA 3 card, so I'll leave it in the card, because it's only like SATA 1 or 2 on the motherboard itself here, so. Let's make sure we're not mashing and hurting anything too awful bad. It's kind of hard to avoid with this case, but I'm going to do the best I can. Alrighty, so we got that there. Oh, we got to do that after it's below the lip. We can't even do the power, so. There we go. That's better. What are we pushing on here? Alrighty, so this is the one that's got the plastic in the end of it here. Let me see if I can show you. You see, it's still got the plastic shoved in the end of it there. That was where I broke it on him. So, let me see if I can elevate this just enough for me to get a bite. Let me bend this as sharp as I can bend it here. So let me show you exactly what the nature of the problem is. The SATA connector is physically longer than the distance between the connector on the drive and the side of the case. Right angle connectors go up, and they're usually, because they're designed for oddly positioned SATA connectors on motherboards, not stupid ass drive bay configurations in the case. Alrighty, I have come to a conclusion. Alright, so let me tell you what I've done so far. I did manage to reverse the SSD in its drive cage so that its cables come out here. They're still kind of mashed, but that keeps them away from the connectors for this drive, so I'm hoping maybe I can get my hands up in there and screw with that one some more. It has a 3.5-inch drive bay, and it has all of no space, unless it's an IDE drive, maybe, to fit the connectors for the drive in here. You can't reverse the drive because, one, the sled only fits one way, and two, you'll be facing into your 5.25-inch drive bay, which, now that we have the optical drive out, I was like, well, maybe there's some punch-outs. There's not. There's no punch-outs. Even if you don't have a drive in here, this 3.5-inch drive has to be facing with its connectors into the side of the case. On top of that, I was like, well, maybe I can take this whole thing out and assemble it, and then, like, stick it in here, this end first. Nope. Everything is fucking riveted. There's the only thing that you can take out of this case, besides the one side panel and the front bezel that you're supposed to be able to remove, is this little 2.5-inch drive bay, and it's not reversible. You can just remove it if you don't want it in there. Oh, my God. The 5.25-inch drive bay sticks back into the power supply almost, and I ordered a TFX power supply specifically for this case. And it's still, if you actually have a 5.25-inch drive in the 5.25-inch drive bay, you can't close it. Alright, so I finally got everything together. I think it's going to work. Biggest pain in the ass case. I went digging around and I finally found a reversed, like a backwards from usual, right angle SATA connector that I was able to get plugged onto this 6 terabyte drive. I'm a little concerned about the connectors on it, but we're going to give it a shot, and if it works as it is, I will raise it back up and glue the connector in place where it's at with super glue so it can't move. But I don't know if you guys can see it, but basically there's a flat, reversed, right angle SATA connector, SATA cable, and it's kind of mashed in between the hard drive and the bay up here and like ran around back to this SATA 3 PCI card over here. But we'll get it hooked up to my monitor and stuff over here and see how it does. That PC connected to power, my keyboard, mouse, display, and speakers. Well, it came on, so that's a good sign. There's one post beep, so everything checked out good. It didn't pick up the big drive. Thought that might happen. I'm gonna have to unhook it again, just so I can fuck around with the SATA cable here. Alright, so I think I found the problem. That SATA cable bent the pins where they're exposed here, so let me put some tweezers and reposition the pins here. Separate them, because they should not be touching. I'm just going to leave it up since everything's plugged in and working and this is locked. I'm just going to leave it like this and plug it in and see if it works. When it comes on, we should have two drives on the screen here. One SanDisk, whatever, and I think the other one's a Seagate. Oh, buddy! Hell yeah! Now here's the thing, once it's up and running, is that a reliable connection or was it just something that was good enough for it to say, oh, it's there? There should be a lot of data on that drive, So what we'll do is we will we'll copy a couple movies from the 6 terabyte to the SSD, and if it's working reliably, I'm going to leave it just like it is and smear the data cable with super glue at all the contact points so that it can't move anymore. Alrighty. Oh. Storage. Videos. There's all the information on it. Alright, so let's list these by size. Here's an 11 gigabyte movie. Let's paste it to the SSD here. See what kind of speeds we get. It doesn't show the speed. But it's going pretty good. There's a gigabyte. There we go. 86. 88, 89, 90 megabytes per second. Seems about right for the drive that we're using. Oh, yeah, it's 5400 RPM, so that's about right. It's done. So now let's see if we watch a movie from the drive. This one's a 10.4 gigabyte file. What the hell did Batman hit Superman with to hurt him?
They told me the world only makes...
Alrighty, so it's all back together. We've got the CPU power cable zip tied to the corner of the cooler here so that it doesn't get pulled into the fan or anything. All the other cables are hidden. No unnecessary stress on that. We've got the storage drive hopefully installed in such a way that the cable doesn't move in the future. If it does, they'll just add some glue to it. Got the front bezel back on it, so... I got a little bit of thermal paste on this from, I was handling it with my hands the other day after I worked on another one. You know, this actually kind of reminds me of like the old school VCRs, like the size and shape and everything. Kind of reminds me of a VCR. And it's kind of bummer that he couldn't get his 5 1/4 inch drive. I'm guessing they probably make shorter TFX power supplies that would have accommodated. Or perhaps if we had been able to find one that was either modular or maybe had flat power cables, it might have worked. But here's this. Here is the PC. So let's hook it up to my stuff and test it one more time. All right, so I'm actually going to use the front audio jack on this. This startup, because I want to test and make sure it's actually working correctly. And contact. Let me see. Two drives. Bam. Debian Linux. Oh my god. Pain in the arse case to work with. Will not be using that one for my future builds. I will get one that uses a standard ATX power supply and actually it has room for the drives that it has bays for. So, let me see. There's audio. Let's check this one out.
Customers are inside the tunnel.
Here we go.
Nothing here.
We'll delete that one. Storage, videos. Let's copy, let me see, we'll list these by size again. Copy a big one over here. Oh, to the desktop. Make sure it's still working alright. So I'm gonna call it good. Go ahead and power off here. All right, so thank you guys for joining me for part of this project anyway. I wish it could have gone a little bit smoother. I'm not particularly fond of that case, but thank you guys for coming along with me anyway. And if you have any comments, questions, concerns, or suggestions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below. And as always, this is Marcus out. Y'all have a good one.